So I've got a takeaway. This is supposed to be desi tea, this. It's too hot. Oh, finally. What I got was Murgh malai, I think. Side salad. Probably not going to be using that. No, no, probably not. They were also selling homemade achai, or achar. I think it's achai. So, I'll have that possibly at home when I get home. Once I get really hungry tonight, which, hey, if anything's happened. I'm guessing that's mint and that's chili sauce. We'll be using the mint chili sauce though. For this, is a Murgh malai, apparently. Spicy. Not very spicy, but I'm spicy. Same piece of chicken marinated in a sauce and it's got a nice kick to it. It's really tender. No, I'll leave it closed. No, good leader. Why not to curse myself? I curse myself now. It's like shut up. I know a lot of you would love me to. No, but thank you all, everybody. To you, back me up when that troll came commenting. Appreciate that. Don't exactly know what makes a desi tea different to normal tea, but can't risk it. Because, of course, I couldn't have any sugar in it, so... It's nice. I'm not much of a tea drinker. So salt is probably lost on me. I wouldn't know an Earl Grey from an Earl Spencer. It's nice. As I said, I don't know much though. Maybe read up about it in a bit. So there you go, Murgh malai and desi tea. Coming up the charts very quickly. So now we're number one now. That's very nice, so I'm going to give that 9 out of 10. And 10 out of 10. So tea that I can drink without needing sugar. It tastes nice. Subscribe.